y'all, it's your girl V Lee back with another video. This time I'm vlogging my entire trip from Atlanta to the West Coast. It's my first time going out there in the truck, so I know it's about to be a different experience. I'm ready for it. Here we go.
Yeah, V Lee.
Okay, so it's gonna take me 3 days to get over there, maybe 3.5, I don't know, depending on how many times I stop. But it's Friday right now, so I should get there maybe Sunday, Monday, sometime. I'm actually going to the West Coast to do a photo shoot and an interview for Swift. Yay, me! My hard work is finally paying off. I've been getting a lot of inquiries about promo and marketing and all of this stuff. So I know 2022 is starting off hella good for me. I'm walking to the office right now. So I'm on the Costco account. But it's not a Costco load that I'm taking to the West Coast. So I don't know if I'm really picking up my paperwork from over here or am I supposed to go to the main terminal. So that's what I'm about to figure out now. I tried to go pick up my trailer yesterday and asked them, can I park it over here at Costco? And they was like, no, it's not a Costco load. Well, I guess I should have called before coming because I have to pick up the paperwork from the main terminal. And now that I think about it, that does make sense, okay? Because, duh, the trailer is over there. So the paperwork is on the trailer. Duh, but... I don't know. My truck is parked here. I'm not gonna go over there now. I'm gonna wait until like 4 o'clock. It's 2:43 now because I don't want my clock to start yet. But in the meantime, I'm about to waste some time, go get me something to eat, and go over my trip plan again, make sure I got all my I's dotted and my T's crossed and stuff like that. Well, this is Atlanta for you. All I want to do is go pick up my trailer. I got 2 exits to go and I've been sitting here for 1.5 hours. I finally made it to the main terminal after 2 hours in traffic. Like, this is so irritating. And then my badge don't work because you got to come over here every 30 days and get it activated. Let's go see if I can activate my badge. My trailer is back there. I went around to try to... Hold on, let me show y'all. I went around and tried to hook up to my trailer. But I don't know, whoever... drop this, like, that was so stupid. Like really, are you serious right now? That caused me to have to hook up to this trailer and pull it up so I can connect to my trailer. I was able to move that trailer out of the way. I didn't connect it to this trailer. I'm doing my pre-trip now. We finally leaving. Lord have mercy. Look at me in the store trying to get snacks, and we went grocery shopping yesterday, so the whole truck is filled up, but my greedy ass gonna get me something else. Showering at the truck stop. Bruh, I feel like I'm at the Motel 6. Look at this. I mean, it's cool, I guess. I see what the real truckers go through. But yeah, all right, I'm about to shower, y'all. Low key, I feel like I'm in jail right now. I didn't even want to brush my teeth, y'all. Good morning, y'all. Parking lot empty. I wonder if it's a real casino or just a slot machine. And I know when you wake up, you gotta go to the bathroom. I've been holding this all night. That might be too much information, but yeah.
I've never been in a casino. They still got their Christmas tree up like me.
We out in the middle of nowhere. But we about to try this Louisiana food place. Hope it's good. It smells like straight pork in here. I'm kind of getting nauseous because I don't eat pork. We got some fish bites, they're real good. I'm out here doing TikTok dances. I know these people in these trucks getting them a good old show out here. 10-hour break over now, it's time to get moving. We stopping in Texas today. So, yeah. I already did my free truck. It's time to get moving. Next day, I didn't finish yesterday. I think the last time that I filmed, we were in San Antonio, but now we're in Fort Stockton, Texas. That was 4 hours? 4 hours away from San Antonio? And then I missed the truck stop, the exit for the truck stop that I was supposed to get off, and it wasn't another truck stop for 70 miles. So, out in the middle of nowhere again. This whole lot was filled last night with trucks, but as y'all can see, it's only me and that truck. And the Loves is all the way over there, so we gotta walk with our bags and stuff because their parking lot is so small. I'm looking at this walk right now, and so last night when we got here was late, of course, so we didn't want to walk in the dark to go shower. But damn, I'm gonna need another shower by the time I walk back to the truck. I just finished taking a shower. That shower is way better than the one from yesterday. I'm eating Carl Jr.'s now, which is pretty much like Hardee's. This is some nice scenery. I just couldn't live out here. Not to mention, the speed limit is 80, but my truck is governed at 65. So, all the trucks keep passing by me. Damn, what are you gonna do, run a man over? Yo, they be driving like a bad kind of hell. Don't be like that, folks. I'm about to take my 30-minute break and get some fuel, but I'm gonna move out the fuel line. I ain't gonna be like the rest of them people. They got Popeyes. I don't know. Should I be fat? I'm so cheap, I did not get Popeyes because I'm not paying $14 for no combo. That's usually $7 to $8. Y'all be trying to rob us, truck drivers. That's crazy. Finally made it to headquarters. Phoenix with transportation. Driver lounge was closed, so we had to go shower at Love's. Good morning, y'all. It's Monday, the day of the shoot, and it's like 8:30 over here, and they texted me talking about, oh, can we shoot at 9? No, I'm tired, actually. Can we do 10? Yeah, but I'm parked at the terminal, about to get ready. I don't even think I'm supposed to be parked right here, because I'm just in the middle of the parking lot, but oh well. I still gotta do my makeup in the truck. I got my little setup going on. Y'all see, I had to bootleg it. I had to make it do what it do in the truck. I feel like I could have did a little better, but. Testing. It's still a little nervous, but yeah.
What's your favorite part about driving?
My favorite part is empowering other women.
So all those buildings up there are just pretty much along Central going north.
Okay. We're eating at this place. It used to be a church. The food looks great.
Is there anything else you all need?
Okay, we're good to go. Thank you.
Ooh, look, a big blue Bertha. Yeah, I should be ashamed of myself. This is my first time I had my truck clean in over a year. And some change. Oh my God. This is the aftermath of that madness this morning. I did not have time to clean up. I was rushing. Man, my truck looked like, whew, honey. Oh my God.
Goodbye, Phoenix. It was nice while it lasted. Yeah, but it's still not enough. Definitely coming back.
Yeah, it's
going to
be time.
Y'all, we at the border in Nogales. Yeah, I was about to miss my exit and head to the border of Mexico, honey. Well, I done had a whole meltdown. Now we going through border and customs. I forgot to vlog some parts today, but I did leave Phoenix. The photo shoot went good. And so now we're at a truck stop in Van Horn, Texas, because I ran out of hours. Today was one for the books, okay? It started off really early. I didn't go off duty until 4 a.m. Monday morning, which is today. And so the photo shoot was at 10 o'clock. I had to get up early, do my hair, do my makeup. My hair look a mess now. And then be at the photo shoot. So then I had to get a truck wash for the photo shoot. And the truck wash guy drove the truck and started my clock. So I had to go jump through hoops, call 3-4 different people to fix my logs, because y'all know how they don't like changing drive time because they feel like you forging federal documents and all that mess right there. But it was really an accident, so they had to fix it. But then, so they had me routed like to San Diego to pick up a load and then drop it off in Houston and then pick up something in Houston and take it to Atlanta or whatever. But luckily, they ended up finding me a load out of Nogales, Arizona. Well, you might as well say Mexico, because it's on the border, back to Atlanta. So let me tell y'all about that. Man, I had a meltdown. down, a true meltdown, like crying because I got frustrated. So I'm driving to Nogales, and then so I start seeing these signs say, oh, the border this and the border that. So the GPS routed me the wrong way. I ended up going down a residential area. We can't do U-turns in the Swift truck. So I kept driving until I found a parking lot big enough. And I swung in the parking lot and then swung out and then alley docked it into the driveway and then made a right turn. But my God, the people were blowing the horn and everything. I'm like, what y'all want me to do? Like, oh my God. I get to the my pickup. The parking is so small. I had to drop off my empty, find somewhere to park that. Then I couldn't locate the trailer that I'm supposed to be bringing back to Atlanta, the loaded trailer. So I'm just, at this point, I'm like, you know what? I had a anxiety attack and I just had to get myself together. It's the next morning. We're waiting on the shower. It's a small love, so I don't even know how long that's gonna take. Hopefully not long. In case y'all wondering why we always stopping at Love's, it's because I be racking up on our reward points, so we get free showers and stuff. Shower ready. This one look a little better. I thought it was gonna look ghetto from the outside. We decided to come walk to the mountain. Lord, this is a long walk. Love's, I can't even see Love's no more. Well, you can see the sign, but it's all the way over there. Here we go, trying something else. This is across from the truck stop.
I don't know. Maybe I should.
Chicken fried steak. So we on the way back to Atlanta, of course. What were we stopping at last night? In Van Horn. Now we on the way to Shreveport. We on the outskirts of Dallas right now. And I'm sleepy. So let's just make it in one piece. Stop to get me some coffee. I only got 2 more hours. I'm looking crazy. We always find the hole in the wall places.
So we just left the truck stop in Greenwood. So we leaving out of Shreveport now. I'm heading to Jackson. And they got a whole bunch of casinos and stuff. So I'm assuming they come here and gamble.
Just had a scare. We at the truck stop in Jackson and it's no parking.
Dang, I just got Bertha clean. Man, I thought we about to be bogged down, y'all. I ain't even gonna cap. Boy, I was finna cry. I was fit to cry. We in Jackson at the Green Ghost Tacos.
I'm ready to eat, sleepy, all day.
And I don't want people to say that, so.
All right, I'm gonna do this one.
No, it's her turn.
Sheesh.
First of all, you can put a draw two on top of a draw.
No, you
can't. We're not playing Nigga Uno. We're
yes,
playing
you
Rebel.
Can. No, yes, you can. Finally back in Atlanta. I didn't even vlog this morning when I left Jackson because I was just so ready to go. Like, today's my last day of the work week. I don't have any more hours to do anything. So I'm taking my behind home. Y'all can see I got little bags. I'm so tired. I know I'm gonna crash once I finally do go to sleep. But I'm waiting to get unloaded. The load that I picked up at the border, I brought it here to Atlanta. And so now I'm waiting to be unloaded. It's like 10 o'clock, what, 10:30? They say they're not gonna unload me until 12:30. So I'm just taking a little nap until the end. I'm almost done getting unloaded, like after 5-6 hours. But I won't complain because technically my appointment time was set for tomorrow, but they're being nice accepting my load today. Overall, the trip wasn't that bad, so I won't complain. It was easier than I thought it was gonna be because I know if I would've went I-40, I probably would've went through mountains and ice and snow and all of that. But I attend the first time going, which was through Houston and San Antonio, El Paso, all of that. And then coming back, I used I-20 and went through like Shreveport, Dallas, and all of that. But yeah, I wouldn't do it again. They can't convince me to drive cross country. And all I probably did close to 4,000 miles or maybe more than 4,000 miles. Yeah, I think so. Anyway, thank y'all for watching. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, share, all of that. Talk to y'all soon.